أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تهتدون. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Assalamu alaikum, Quran Weekly. A very high, heavy ayah to share with you today. It's the 103rd ayah of Surah Ali Imran. Just some lessons from it, inshallah ta'ala. Hopefully you and I can both take them to heart and change ourselves in light of them. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Al-i'tisam is used in Arabic to hold on to something for protection. Isma is protection. I'tisam, to protect yourself. To hold on to something in order to protect yourself. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ, hold on to the protection, or hold on to the rope of Allah, جَمِيعًا, all together, also means hold on to the entire rope of Allah. The rope of Allah in this ayah, obviously a rope is something that connects you to something else. حَبْلُ اللَّهِ, even the expression حَبْلُ اللَّهِ, the rope of Allah, the grammatical construction of it suggests that these two words are inseparable. It's called an idafa in Arabic. But I won't get too technical. All I want to share with you is, it is as though Allah is saying this rope directly connects to Allah. And you better hold on to it for protection. And if you do, you will be directly connected to Allah. And that rope of Allah, as the Prophet would describe it, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is the Quran itself. So وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا, all together. In other words, us coming closer to the Quran is a collective affair. We have to do this together. I have to help you get closer to the Quran. You have to help me get closer to the Quran. This is something we all need each other for. It's not an individual exercise. Then all on top of that, jami'an. In other words, don't take one part of the Quran and ignore other parts of the Quran. You should be on a quest to try to understand and internalize as much of the Quran as you can. And when something of the Quran comes to you that you didn't know before, you should joyously come in, you know, and you should receive it. Obviously, it's going to be a long journey before you and I entirely understand the whole Quran, you know, and maybe is not going to happen in our lives, but at least now we know what we have to work towards. Allah says, وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا, while not falling into disagreement with each other. And it's interesting that the word اختلاف, which is disagreement, is one side, but the word here is تَفَرَّقُوا, which is to break yourselves up into factions. That would be the way I would describe the word تَفَرَّقُوا. So Allah is literally saying, focus on His word and stop becoming divided into factions. Stop defining yourself as part of one group or another group or another group or another group, in a way that you are only doing so to distinguish yourself from some other entity, to be able to say that they're not right and I am, or they're not right and those guys are. Stop doing this. Come closer to the rope of Allah, hold on to it for protection. Why are you getting distracted by becoming divided altogether? You know, and by the way, when people hold on to the same rope, naturally they come physically close to each other, right? So Allah is saying, when we focus on the Quran, when we make that the central discourse for ourselves, then naturally there's going to be more and more unity among us, subhanAllah. There are those of us that are from different backgrounds, we speak different languages. You know, nowadays English is becoming more of a shared language, so people are watching these videos all over the world, right? But you know what our real common language is? Actually, the reason you're watching this video even is the Quran. It's not me, it's nothing about me. It's actually the Quran, it's the word of Allah. And I hope that Allah brings our hearts together closer and closer and closer with every minute, every second even we spend just trying to listen to even the recitation of the Quran or an explanation of the Quran. And this is actually a natural result of the Quran, that you stop becoming divisive. Like, you don't think about division. You don't think about what makes you different from other Muslims or how you can pick out their flaws and things like that. So you have to ask yourself, and I have to ask myself, if I'm constantly critical of other scholars, other groups, other schools of thought, other Muslims and what they're doing, and at the same time I think I'm learning the Book of Allah, maybe I'm not. Because those two things don't go hand in hand. That attitude just starts leaving you the more you get involved with Allah's book. So Allah then says, وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً. Look at that. Mention the favor of Allah unto you when you used to be enemies.
How do we implement this in Ramadan? You know, in subhanAllah, in Ramadan, maybe you're going to the masjid more than you've ever gone before. Or maybe you never ever go to the masjid and now you're going to the masjid. So you're going to see other Muslims. You know, and there are Muslims that are different from you, you know. If you don't have a beard, you see a guy with a beard, usually you might think, ah, these guys, man, they're so crazy, they're so extreme, they're so judgmental. You're a sister who doesn't normally wear hijab, you walk into the masjid in Ramadan, all these women are covered. You're only covered because you're in the, you know, in the masjid for the first time, or, you know, and you're like thinking, man, if these women knew what I'm really like, they'd be so judgmental of me. And the other way around too, those people, you know, they have ill feelings towards you, you have ill feelings towards them. This is the time to test the mettle of this ayah. Mention the favor of Allah unto you when you used to be enemies. So he's the one who put love between you. Now at the end of that statement even, it was enough for him to say he put love between you and made you into brothers. But he went further and said, فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. You, especially by his favor, and only by his favor, transformed into becoming brothers. Isbah is used when something completely transforms. And isbah is also for the morning to happen. It's as though you were in night, and it's like a new morning came into you when you found brotherhood with your fellow Muslims. SubhanAllah. That is the description of Allah, you know, talking about his favor, that we feel softness towards other Muslims. You know, in an age where we're constantly criticizing movies, criticizing video games, on top of that, criticizing scholars of the past. There are people who don't even spare the prophets. There are people who outside of the religion don't even spare criticizing God. And within our religion, there are people who criticize, you know, the great ulama of the past, and they don't spare people even nowadays. They'll criticize other Muslims, other du'at. They'll criticize entire organizations, student groups. They criticize their friends. They criticize their local imam. We're just so bent on criticism. We love doing it. Where is the favor of Allah where you feel this brotherhood towards the other? That even if they're wrong, you want to go and give them a hug and share with them how much you care about them, and then maybe try to fix them in the most courteous, respectful way. Where did it go? This is what we have to revive in Ramadan. فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. You became brothers once again. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَىٰ شَفَىٰ حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. You were all at the very edge of the fire and he rescued you from it. Now, Allah is now saying that you were rescued from the fire after he describes that you became brothers. It is as though your brotherhood was how Allah rescued you from the fire. It's your brotherhood that kept you away from evil. SubhanAllah. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَىٰ شَفَىٰ حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. That is how Allah clarifies His miraculous signs to you so you can be committed to guidance. Now Allah says these, you know, it's the last thing I'm sharing with you in this message. Al-ihtida, to be committed to guidance, to be firm on guidance yourself. This is a general term. Guidance is everything under the sun, but that has to do with Islam. Prayer is part of being guided. Hajj is part of being guided. Reciting Quran is part of being guided. Being truthful is part of being guided. You can't think of anything within Islam that you can't call a part of the guidance of Allah. But when Allah puts it specifically at the end of an ayah, it is tied to what Allah mentioned in that ayah. So now Allah is saying that your attitude towards your brother, the love that you feel towards your brother in Islam, as a result of the love Allah put inside of you, He did that so that you can manifest guidance. That itself is a manifestation of guidance. May Allah Azza wa Jalla allow us to show every manifestation of guidance in our lives. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum everyone. If you benefited from these reminders, please support Quran Weekly by clicking the link below.